What's good, YouTube? It is Friday, New Year's Eve. Pretty sure both have the government flu, the Omarion variant.
The who?
The Omarion.
Omicron.
Omarion.
Icebox where my heart used to be.
Anyway, we got a truck to build. We're going to build it. First thing this morning,
shocks. So, with your Nfamus kit, Nfamus, their C-notch is already built, and it's made to just cut the frame out and slide in. Ours is quarter-inch frame. Ours is quarter-inch plate that welds to the outside. By doing that, you create a rubbing problem. So, what we're going to do this morning is we're going to take some of this scrap quarter inch that I have that already has some nice holes drilled in that are the same size as the shocks. And instead of the shock mounting down here on the side of the lower bar, we're actually going to put some tabs on top just to space it out. Should work. We might have to throw in a little spacer right here, but I'd rather do that, change up the design just a little bit. I'd rather do that than be sitting there rubbing, messing up the shock. We could cut the dust shield off of the shock, but then every time the customer needed to change the shocks, he'd have to cut it. So we want it to be simple.
Like it should be, where you just, undo the two bolts and change it out. So we got to do the shocks. Once we're done with the shocks, we've got to cut the bed out. Then we put the bed on, start mounting the stuff for plumbing. Front's pretty much done at this point. We have to put the sway bar in. And then on the driver's side, there is some things that need to be relocated. ECU, fuse box, and ABS, the big ABS module. We're gonna build tabs and all that stuff for that. Don't worry, you'll go on the ride with us. Yeah, our plan was to test drive this thing New Year's Day or Sunday. I didn't work on this thing yesterday. I was tired. I had some things I needed to do around the house. So we might not test drive this thing tomorrow, but hey, our boy Phillip's not in no hurry, no rush. He just wants his truck done and done right. So for one, that's why he brought it to Carport Customs and didn't give us a deadline.
All right, so we got the shock tabs redone. Put them on top of the frame. I mean on top of the lower bars. Pulled them out a little bit. We got to get some shorter bolts, build a little spacer. Only thing left we have to do now is cut out the bed. Get the factory fender wells cut out for the C-notch. I measured from the factory bed mount to the edge of the bottom of the C-notch where it connects to the frame. It's like 10 inches. I went an extra half inch. Same thing on the front from this bolt, and then just came in, measured it from here, measured it down, drew me a line. I'm gonna cut out around this fender well and then across. Same thing on the bottom, and then you've got to cut it out even here. And then we'll have to trim the fender lip too. So we'll break out the plasma. All right, so right here, we're just using the plasma to cut this bed out to make room for the C-notch and the suspension to come up through the bed. We marked it out, we measured it. I like to cut a little short on everything because it's hard to add metal back. You can always keep trimming until the bed fits. I cut around the fender wells. I try to keep as much strength in this bed as possible. You don't want it to be all flimsy. I like to just follow along where the bed floor meets the fender wells. Right here, I'm cutting where the bed floor meets the bed side. I cut because it's connected, but you don't want to cut too much. say, so you can leave some strength so your bed side isn't flapping in the wind as you go up and down the road. We cut it and then we grind back with a grinder and everything for the fitment of the wheels. And if you don't have a plasma, you can use the good old death wheel. It always works. But when using the death wheel, it's a little tricky to get into some of the spots around the fender wells and to make curves around the fender wells. I like to use my plasma. It makes quick work of it. Don't be scared to cut your bed. Take some measurements. Make sure you measure your C-notch because you don't want to overcut. I measure from the bed mounts to the C-notch, give it about a half an inch, and start cutting away on it. You can't be afraid to cut on your truck. Just be mindful when you're cutting. If you're going to use a cutting wheel, good old death wheel, try to have a good face shield. So if it comes apart, don't take you out. I'm really sorry that we don't have more footage of this bed cut out. I'm new to this YouTube thing and new to filming. I'm used to just working. Sometimes I forget to turn the camera on, or I've got it sitting at the wrong angle and I'm in the way of the camera. If you guys have any questions or anything like that, you can get at us on our Facebook page at Carport Customs YouTube. The link is in the description. Feel free to ask us any questions. We'll get back with you. If I've got to do a personal little video for you for anything, I will. FaceTime you, whatever it takes. We want to help you guys that need help on getting these projects done. That's what we're here for. So please, you know, get at us if you need to. And enjoy the rest of the video.
Well, we're done for the day. Just kind of wore out. We got the bed cut out.
Got the back finished. We have the bed cut out. Everything. We still have to, there's the bed cross member that runs across here. You have to cut it for the raised gas.
Hey, look, check this out real quick. You got a truck you need bagged? Did you buy somebody's hack job off of Facebook? Do you have just a stock ride that it's time to lay out, but you don't know how to do it, or you just don't have time to do it? Comment below, get at us on Facebook, Carport Customs. We're right here in Sulphur, Louisiana. We can get you on the ground the right way and the safe way. That's the biggest thing. Anybody can put a truck on the ground, but ask yourself, would you ride behind it on the highway? So if you want a safe, reliable, daily bag truck, come get at us at Carport Customs.
There we go. All right, so we're back in the shop, day
876.
Yep. So we found out. We found out that this truck was actually rear-ended, and it had, when we put this new bed on, the gap was messed up. It was actually tight at the top. So we checked the frame and everything. Everything was good until we got past the C-notch. It was actually hit in this back passenger side corner, and it had the frame twisted like this. So we wound up mounting the bed, and we probably cut the back of the frame, pulled it down, and got it straight.
Just so happens that the great YouTuber I am, forgot the damn camera at the house, so now we're going to get the rear tubs welded in. We're gonna do a little sheet metal repair down in here to tie everything in together real nice. After we get done with this, we have in the front You got to put the sway bar in. We actually got all this stuff mounted now. Built some brackets. Built us a little bracket there.
Okay, so right here, we had cut out the bed and we trimmed the spots for the inner fenders. It's just some trailer fenders from Tractor Supply. Just got to get them in there, get them where you want them. Make sure they're even, make sure they're level. Get them tacked in. And after you get them tacked in, get them where you want them, then start welding them in. You just don't want to weld in one spot. The truck metal is pretty thin. So you just want to do like you would do any other body work, metal work, thin metal fab. Is just hit a spot here, go over to the other side, hit a couple spots, you know, and just rotate back and forth. Right here, these were some brackets that came with the ABS, that come from ABS for the Vi-Air 485s. They come in pieces. I think it was like three pieces. You have to weld them together. That's what we're doing right here. It's just a little stand to make your compressors look a little better, kind of elevates them a little bit. It actually makes them a little quieter. They have little rubber insulators that go on them. And it quietens them down, just makes it look a little more appealing than being bolted flat to the bed or wherever you're gonna bolt them. That nice tattoo. And that's the finished product, all welded up. Oh, youngster throwing in them dimes.
ABS compressor mounts. Yes, indeed.